It's hard to believe that 10 years ago tonight, the Hershey Bears won their 11th Calder Cup in absolutely spectacular fashion, coming back from being down 0-2. And I'm so excited, I'm so happy that I'm joined by the MVP of those Calder Cup playoffs, number 17 on the ice, number one in your hearts, Chris Bork. Borky, thank you so much for joining me tonight.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So I want to go back really quickly through this season, but I want to start back in 2009 with Manitoba, when you guys go up there and win the cup. I look back at that roster, it was so many guys on entry-level contracts that you were going to have so much of the same core coming back the next year. After you guys won the cup in 2009, was there a feeling that there was a good chance you guys could go and do it again?
Yeah, I mean, going back to 2009, you know, we had such a good team. We had such a good run there, obviously winning in Manitoba. A lot of the same guys coming back, like you said. We didn't really know what to expect coming into the next year, but we knew we were going to have a good team. With that said, our division is always good, and you never know, running into a Wilkes-Barre or, you know, whoever it was, Bridgeport, Albany. It's always a stacked division, hard games, hard-fought games. So you never really know what to expect, but we knew that we were going to have a good team and make a good run at going back-to-back, but you never know.
So then you start the year in Pittsburgh in 2009-10 and end up joining the team back in December. I remember that night scoring the Teddy Bear toss goal and sort of the run that you guys went on afterwards. I want to just run off some numbers here that I checked out earlier. So the night before, the Bears lose to Albany for their seventh loss of the year. The next night starts a run where the team goes 45-10-1 the rest of the season, only winning 10 games. And those next 40 games after you joined, the team went 35-5. What was it like being on a team that only loses 5 games out of their next 40 and goes on the runs that you guys did?
It was great. I mean, I think we had so much momentum going in from the year before that I wasn't there for the beginning of the year, but I would imagine they were like, hey, boys, same team, pretty much. Let's just keep it going. And they did. And when I came, it just kind of steamrolled and snowballed and kept going. And the guys that we had in that locker room, we had a blast together. We had so much fun together on and off the ice. That made it so much better. And we just carried the momentum throughout the whole year. Great coaching staff. We just had so much fun together, like I said. And we had such a wagon. We had such – every line, it was, our team was so deep. I mean, just watching these games going back, it's insane how good our team was. And it's fun to watch, and it was really fun to be a part of it. It just brings back so many good memories.
So I want to really run quickly through the playoffs before we get to the finals here with each round. So in the first round, you face off against Bridgeport, and that first game, honestly, I think is the game people remember the most with the – We can say it now. It was a high stick. 10 years later, I think we can say it was a high stick from Matthew Perreault that sends it to overtime and kind of sets the tone for that series. What do you remember about that Bridgeport series?
That's literally the only thing I remember about it, but that high stick probably doesn't matter. We're going to beat them no matter what.
So then you go into round two, and it's an absolute, 3 overtime games against Albany and then winning that series there. Just what a sort of run that round was.
Yeah, I mean, I think we swept them, right? But yeah, so that series was a lot closer, obviously, than a sweep. I think you said, right, 3 overtime games. It was a hard-fought series. I remember that. You squeak out 3 overtime games and you sweep a team. I mean – and I think we might have got Carlson and Alzner back that series because Washington lost to Montreal, I believe. That obviously helps you out when you get those two guys. Obviously, they were young and rookies, but at the same time, they were our 1-2 defensemen when they came back down. So that obviously helped us and helped us probably win the cup because without them, who knows what happens. But, yeah, it was a hard-fought series for sure.
And then you go into another big series in round three against Manchester with three overtime victories there. You kick it off with the – obviously, you guys go up 2-0 with your overtime goal. What do you remember about that overtime goal with the net getting kicked off there, then you celebrating the entire length of the ice in Giant Center?
Yeah, I think a little bit of controversy. They were kind of arguing that the net might have been off. I remember Kaner chipping out to Coyner, and me and Coyner on a 2-on-1, and, I mean, best passer probably in the history of the AHL with Keith Coin, and I knew I just had to get open and hit my one-timer, hit the net, and it's in, and the goalie kicked it off and just start celebrating, and, yeah, it was fun.
Still counts today. It doesn't really matter if anybody's arguing back a decade ago. So then you go to game six with Boyd Kane's goal in overtime to win it. Just, I think, pandemonium. Obviously, you remember the game seven goal with Eric Ferris sending you guys to the Cup in 06. But this one, I think, is just as big with people remembering sending you guys there in such a hard-fought battle. What are the emotions every time you get a chance to go back to the Calder Cup Finals, especially winning a game like that?
Yeah, I mean, I would draw comparisons of that to when Boyd scored against Wilkes in Game 7 against them to send us to the conference finals. I know it's two different things, but when you win in such a big fashion to send you off to a big stage like the conference finals or the finals, it's more of a relief than a celebration. You just see, you're like, oh my God, I can't believe this happened. Like, cause you're so nervous in overtime, obviously next goal wins. And when your team scores, you're just like, thank God, let's go celebrate and get the F off the ice. Like, it's just so exciting. And that's the best part about our sport and playoffs is overtime goals. You just celebrate with your buddies, celebrate on the ice, and then go hang out in the locker room and talk about how fun it was.
So then you go into the finals here, and you guys are obviously rolling at this point, but you start at home and you go down 0-2. Can you just kind of talk about what sort of the feeling was going through that entire playoffs to then get to that point and feel like, oh, geez, we just dropped two at home, being the best, home team in the playoffs the entire run, best home team the entire regular season, and you guys just you can't get it done those first two games?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it wasn't – the position that we wanted to be in, going down 2-0 in front of, our home fans. At the same time, they had a really good team. Jamie Benn, Travis Morin, their goalie was good. They had some good veteran defensemen. Not that we took them lightly going into it, but I think we were so confident. We were like, we're going to beat them. Doesn't matter. And ended up being true, but going down 2-0 isn't the way you want to start at home. And then obviously we had some really good meetings with, we had really good veteran leadership. We had Helms, Kane, Giroux, Acoin, the list goes on, and those guys kind of kept us younger guys in check. And we're like, hey, we're still in this. We win the next game and we're right back in the series. And that's what happened.
Was there a meeting at one point with Helms going in and kind of going around to everybody saying, here's something you're doing well, here's something we need to work on? Was there a meeting like that? So can you talk about that meeting at all and what that was like? Because I remember that story and kind of being like, whoa, that's kind of a good – not a cool moment per se, but kind of a moment there to get you guys going and really focus on what you had to do.
Yeah, that's what made Helms such a good captain. He knew how to press everyone's buttons the right way. And, he was always so positive. It was when we landed in Texas, and it was it was the day before the game, and we had a closed door meeting with just the guys, and he went around and he was like, listen, boys, we're still on this. We just got to play our game. He said, everybody knows their roles. He went down the room. Everybody knows what they're supposed to do. Just do what you need to do. And it kind of put us back in the mindset where maybe get back to basics. And that's what we needed to do as a team, is get back to basics and not try to be too flashy or, do it all yourself or something. Maybe we were trying to force it too much the first couple games. And I don't want to give Helms too much credit because, he's the man there, but he really showed up that day and showed why he was our captain. You know, we all voted him captain, and he showed his true colors.
So then we go into that game three down there, and you guys get behind early. What was sort of the mood coming out of the locker room that second period in game three?
It was tough. I remember, I'm not blaming any of this on Newbie, but I remember him coughing up a puck and them scoring on the PP, and I think they might have went up 2-1 or maybe 2-0. And we were just like, oh, my God, like, what else is going to go wrong in this series? Like, we had the best power play in the league by far the whole year, and they're scoring on us like this. And, I mean, maybe that was rock bottom for us, and that's what needed to happen to us. And then we just came out and kind of played like we had nothing to lose, because we didn't at that moment. We were down 2-0 in the game, 2-0 in the series, on the road with three games there, and yeah, the rest is history. We kind of just manned up and got the job done.
It really felt like that game was the moment where you just hit the switch and it's like, okay, here we go. Let's just see what we can do here. And it snowballed in from game three into game four. And then you get to game five with that overtime goal, which is just still one of my all-time favorite moments in Hershey Bears history. What was your perspective on the goal? What was obviously we get to see the video camera from high center ice view of it, but from where you were on the ice and from where you were in that arena, what do you remember about Drew putting that puck five hole and sending you guys three up to come back home?
Yeah, I mean, I think going into overtime, we were just like, let's get this done and the series is over. We knew we weren't going to win or lose at home again. Ended up with the best goal scorer and probably in my era, best goal scorer in the history of my era with the puck on his stick. He's not missing that in overtime. He's such a clutch player. I think he had 73 goals that year, which is probably the most insane stat in this era with the goalies that we're shooting against. This guy is just lights out with the puck in the slot. And I think everyone already had one leg over the bench when he had the puck where he was. And we just kind of started buzzing off the ice when he scored 5-0. And it was pandemonium on the bench, and then the whole rest of the night, I think we might have flew home that night, and it was like we already won the cup at that point, to be honest.
So then you do get to come back and you still have one game to play, but I mean, obviously that building was buzzing, you guys were buzzing, you win 4-0. What about that night in that building with everybody there and being the first cup that you guys get to win in front of the home fans during that run? What do you remember about June 14th, 2010?
To be honest, that's pretty much the only game I remember the series. Like, I've been watching them back, and I'm like, I don't remember literally one play in any of these games. I know every single thing that happened in game six. And all the goals were scored by defensemen. I remember that. The first power play goal by Carlson. I mean, we were a little bit nervous going into it because the year before we thought we were going to win at home against Manitoba, and we absolutely killed them in the game and lost and then had to go there and win. So we were like, boys, let's not mess this up. And we went in, dominated, I think, the whole game. Carlson scores, and that just set the roof on fire. And from there, we were just buzzing, and there was no stopping us.
And I remember that night being on the ice and everybody having their families there and everybody having, you know, obviously you guys were such a tight group doing it 2 years in a row, but having everybody's family there, having everybody around, what was that like being on the ice with so many people, not just your teammates, but so many people that meant so much to you in your career, in your life and everything?
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, the previous two cups that we won were on the road, so it was a little bit tough to get everybody down there. So I think having it at home, having a chance to win at home, everyone got to get their families down. I remember I had my parents there, my brother, my sister, my uncle. The list goes on, and everyone was on the ice. I mean, there was probably like 2,000 people on the ice. Everyone had the same thing. It was awesome. It was just, we still have a team. We had a whole team picture with every single family member and all that. And it was awesome. It's just a huge crowd of people. And then celebration for, you know, 5 to 7 days and just enjoy it. No stress going back home. You know, you win it at home and celebrating our own locker room and all that whole thing. So it was fun. It was, I mean, you can't even really explain it.
So then I got one last question for you, because obviously there's only a couple guys. There's only about 20, 30 people that can say they were a part of the 2010 Hershey Bears. As somebody that was a part of that group, that very small elite group of, in my opinion, I think in a lot of people's opinion, the best team in American Hockey League history, what do you think the legacy of that team should be?
I mean, for me personally, I think it's the best team in the history of the league. I don't think there's a question about that. I'm not a statistician. I don't know. I mean, I know a lot about the history of leagues. I played in it for so long, and I have respect for the whole league. But, you know, we won 60 games that year, maybe more or less.
60 on the nose.
60. We won 60 games in an 80-game schedule. I mean, we set the record for home games too, I think.
Yep, home games. It was 24 in a row, 34 home wins overall. So you only lost 6 at home the entire year. Just, I mean, you go down the stat list, and it's absolutely amazing the things you guys accomplished.
Yeah, and I mean, the individual accomplishments with Giroux breaking the Brett Hull's record, scoring 73 goals, no one will ever touch that. I'll tell you that right now. You know, him and Keith DeCoin were just lights out for those 2 years, and our team was kind of unfair how good we were, to be honest. And it's a tip of the cap to Washington for drafting well and then signing good veteran players. And it was a treat to be a part of. I'm sure the fans enjoyed that hockey. And I'm just happy I was part of it. You know, I was along for the ride. I was there for – that was probably my 5th year. And it was awesome. I mean, nothing against the other Calder Cup teams. And I went to – you know, 5 Calder Cup finals. That was the best team by far, I think.
Absolutely. Absolutely. 100% agree about that. Well, Borky, thank you so much for chatting, going back down memory lane with me. I hope everybody that's watching right now enjoyed this chat. If you haven't seen yet, the Hershey Bears are rebroadcasting all the games on their social media. So tonight at 7 p.m., game 6 of the 2010 Calder Cup finals, you can watch it live and relive all the great memories. Borky, again, thank you so much. Hope everything's well.
Hope everything's going well. Go Bears.